Good morning.
Good morning.
Today, I'd like to offer a special word of welcome to Deacon Steven Castillo, who will be joining us for his five-month transitional diaconate internship with us here at St. Jeremy Parish. So please take a moment following Mass today to offer a word of welcome to Deacon Steven. We're looking forward to having you serve us and join Father Eric and I in our ministry here at St. Jeremy. Today we celebrate the memorial of St. Justin Martyr. Please join me in the entrance antiphon. The wicked have told me lies, but not so is your law. I spoke of your decrees before kings and was not confused. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Let us take a moment to call to mind our sin.
We're sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, through the folly of the cross, wondrously taught St. Justin the Martyr the surpassing knowledge of Jesus Christ. Grant us through his intercession that having rejected deception and error, we may become steadfast in the faith through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Tobit. On the night of Pentecost, after I had buried the dead, I, Tobit, went into my courtyard to sleep next to the courtyard wall. My face was uncovered because of the heat. I did not know there were birds perched on the wall above me till their warm dropping settled in my eyes, causing cataracts. I went to see some doctors for a cure, but the more they anointed my eyes with various salves, the worse the cataracts became, until I could see no more. For 4 years I was deprived of eyesight, and all my kinsmen were grieved at my condition. Akbar, however, took care of me for 2 years until he left for Elymas. At that time, my wife Anna worked for hire at weaving cloth, the kind of work women do. When she sent back the goods to their owners, they would pay her. Late in winter on the 7th of Dicerus, she finished the cloth and sent it back to the owners. They paid her a full salary and also gave her a young goat for the table. On entering my house, the goat began to pee. I called to my wife and said, "Where did this goat come from? Perhaps it was stolen. Give it back to its owners. We have no right to eat stolen food." She said to me, "It was given to me as a bonus over and above my wages." Yet I would not believe her and told her to give it back to its owners. I became very angry with her over this. So she retorted, "Where are your charitable deeds now? Where are your virtuous acts? See, your true character is finally showing itself." The word of the Lord. The heart of the just one is firm, trusting in the Lord.
The heart of the just one is firm, trusting in the Lord.
Bless the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed. The heart of the just one is firm, trusting in the Lord. An evil report fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steadfast. He shall not fear till he looks down upon his foes.
The heart of the just man is firm, trusting in the Lord.
Lavishly he gives to the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His arm shall be exalted in glory.
The heart of the just man is firm, trusting in the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Some Pharisees and Herodians were sent to Jesus to ensnare him in his speech. They came and said to him, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man, and that you are not concerned with anyone's opinion. You do not regard a person's status, but teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not? Should we pay or should we not pay?" Knowing their hypocrisy, he said to them, "Why are you testing me? Bring me a denarius to look at." They brought one to him, and he said to them, "Whose image and inscription is this?" They replied to him, "Caesar's." So Jesus said to them, "Repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." They were utterly amazed at him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we hear this famous line from Jesus, "To give to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to give to God what is God's." All of us in our daily lives encounter the gift of our faith and also the gift of our worldly concerns. And oftentimes it's here in this church, in this daily morning mass, as we come at 7 a.m., as we offer our day to God, that we have the intersection of our faith and our worldly concerns. For many of us as daily mass goers, we come here to begin our day, to offer our day to God, to ask God to bless our day as we go forth into our day to face those different concerns. Last night I was just spending some time in the chapel praying before going to bed. I didn't particularly hear the voice of God speak to me or be moved in, you know, a particular revelatory way like that, but yet just related my heart to God. Just spent time praying before going to bed, just bringing the day, the people I encountered the day, my petitionary prayer to Jesus, the most blessed sacrament, just offering it to God. For many of us, sometimes, you know, we may feel like we'd like to hear that boomer box voice of the Lord, hear him speak directly to us, and he often does at times within the voice of our own hearts, but yet, more often than not, it's simply being in God's presence and bringing our day before him and asking his blessing upon our day, that we truly give to God what is God's. We cannot avoid the worldly concerns of life. Today in our first reading and throughout this week, we'll hear from the book of Tobit. The book of Tobit, with his wife and then his child, Tobias and daughter-in-law, are already going to hear a lot of family drama, a lot of real worldly concerns. Today we hear of Tobit's sickness, and even in his sickness, his wife becomes upset with him over other matters. He's facing many worldly concerns, and he tries to remain faithful to the Lord. Today, as we celebrate the memorial of St. Justin Martyr, St. Justin was a second century saint, and he was a philosopher. He was a thinker. He was a man who discerned many different ways of viewing the world. In a sense, he struggled with those worldly concerns too, seeking the right way to journey through this life. It wasn't until he stumbled upon Christianity that he said, they have the truth. And even when the Roman procurator challenged Justin, Justin said, I am a Christian, and he refused to acknowledge the pagan gods of Rome. And for it, he lost his head. Justin faced the worldly intersection of the world and faith, and he simply remained truthful to the Lord and truthful to the gospel. And he allowed God to guide him through this life, even leading him to martyrdom. Dear brothers and sisters, at times there may be worldly concerns in our lives. Perhaps we may not know the way to navigate them. As we continue in this season of Pentecost, let's just call upon the Holy Spirit to guide us each and every day. Let's continue to begin our day with the Lord, asking him to bless our day. And let us end our day by bringing it back to the Lord, once again asking for his blessing. Even though things may not always work out perfectly or perhaps the way we want, we remain faithful that God has a plan for us each and every day. And if we remain faithful to him, submit our wills to God's will, that the Lord ultimately will bring about our salvation. With our hope firmly planted in God, let us bring our petitions before him. For the Holy Catholic Church, that she may remain ever faithful to her Lord and proclaim his good news to the ends of the world, we pray to the Lord. For government leaders, especially in our own country, that they may enact laws ordered towards the common good of all people, we pray to the Lord. For us gathered here today, that we may be guided by the spirit of wisdom and understanding in our interactions with all those we encounter, we pray to the Lord. In silence, let us offer our own petitions. We pray to the Lord. Father, you are the source of all good things. We ask that you hear and answer our prayers and help us share the good news through Christ our Lord. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, we pray, Lord, that we may celebrate worthily these mysteries which St. Justin strenuously defended through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. The blood of your blessed water, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble we still strength to bear you witness. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, before your majesty without end we acclaim, Holy. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, they have led us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Shelton, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Have the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, bless Joseph, her spouse, for the blessed apostles and all the saints, with St. Justin Martyr. We have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy of the issue of doing my roof, but I want to say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Prayer of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. As I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come with you spiritually into my heart. Embrace you as you were already there. Unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The distribution of Holy Communion, we will continue to invite everyone to walk up, forming two lines, and we'll receive communion at the feet of the altar. Let us pray. Refreshed by heavenly food, we humbly implore you, O Lord, that attentive to the teaching of St. Justin the Martyr, we may abide at all times in thanksgiving for the gifts we have received through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may God bless you in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We got all excited. We had the new deacon to go introduce him. Forgot we had our perpetual help on Tuesday. So for those who would like to remain, we'll offer our perpetual help devotion. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Most holy, Immaculate Virgin, and our Mother Mary, you are our perpetual help, our refuge, and our hope. Mother, perpetual help, confident of your powerful influence with God, obtain for us these graces. Let us kneel to pray as a community of faith. Mary, all generations have called you blessed, and the Almighty has done great things for you. Let us pray for our temporal wants. Let us stand now to present our petitions and our thanks. Lord Jesus Christ, at a word from Mary, your mother, you changed water into wine at Cana of Galilee. Listen now to the people of God gathered here to honor our mother with perpetual help. Grant our petitions and accept our sincere thanks. Grant wisdom and guidance to our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Bob, our priests, and all the leaders of our nation, state, and community. Grant peace and unity throughout the world, especially in our homes and families. Hear us, Lord. Hear us. Grant that young people respond generously to the call of the Holy Spirit, deepening their faith and choosing their vocations in life. Grant us continued health of mind and body, and of the sick especially, to regain their health according to your holy will. Grant eternal rest to all our deceased especially, and to the souls of all the faithful departed. Let us pause now to silently present our own petitions to our Mother of Perpetual Help. Lord, accept our thanks for the new life of grace you gave us. Accept our thanks for all the graces received through the sacramental life of the Church. Accept our thanks for the spiritual and material blessings we have received. Let us pause now to silently thank our Mother Perpetual Help for our own favors received. Please kneel as we pray for the sick. Lord, look upon us. This we ask you, who live and reign.